I am. Oh my god. Oh my god. Is that Vino?
Is that Vino?
Oh boy. Oh my god. Am I really about to go meet Grayscale right now? Everything now that I remember, it came back to me in waves throughout the night. Bearings is in the circle pit right now. Good morning, besties. A change of scenery from where I normally am, obviously. I am in Boston's North End right now because I am seeing and also meeting Grayscale today on the last day of their Summer Dream Tour. And I am disgustingly nervous for today. So much so that I did not sleep, really, at all. I've never seen Grayscale before, I've never met Grayscale before, and like any sort of like VIP, like meet and greet sort of thing makes me nervous. But at home, for like the past week, I was just like trembling uncontrollably 24/7. But I got here yesterday and I was just like, oh, I'm chill, I'm good. Like, I'm gonna meet Grayscale tomorrow, this is fine. And I was more like excited, but I wasn't like shaking and just like didn't know what to do with myself. But then like when it came to like trying to sleep, that's when it was just like, oh no, 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 no. You are incredibly nervous, you are not gonna sleep. Like, this is not good. But yeah, so I got here last night and I'm glad I came early because getting here was absolutely atrocious. It took pretty much twice as long as it should have to get here because there were problems with the train tracks on the line that I was taking. The track just literally broke because it was too hot. Also, I have never been to the North End before. I don't come to Boston very often unless it's for concerts or like traveling south of Massachusetts. So like normally when I go to concerts, it's at the House of Blues, the Royale, or the Aganis Arena. So it's my first time ever being in the North End, first time ever at Big Night Live, of course, first time ever seeing and meeting Grayscale. I am, oh my god, oh my god. But now I am shaking uncontrollably because I am meeting Grayscale today and it's happening. Like, I look at the clock like counting down the hours, like I'm meeting them so soon. It's 8 a.m. We, according to the website, have to show up at 4:45, but I might go a little bit earlier just because that's just how I roll. I'm usually early. I mean, like, I'm literally here the day before, like they weren't even here. But also, I have found quite a handful of people from Twitter who are also going, and they're kind of, it seems like, coming in from a while away, so that's fun. But I think we're gonna stick together, and I think we also all have VIP, so that's exciting. I'm excited to meet some people because I am going by myself, and that for some reason this time is making me incredibly nervous. I've done so many shows by myself, but for some reason this is the one where I'm like, nah, I can't be by myself. I don't know how concerts work anymore suddenly. I need to shower, I need to go get food. I have to try and eat today somehow, which is not gonna happen. I'm so nervous and so like nauseous because I'm nervous. Yeah, I don't know, I feel like at this point I am just repeating myself over and over and over again because I'm stressed. Oh my god, why does my window keep making that noise? Please stop. But yeah, I'm just, oh my god, I'm so nervous. So I don't know when I'm gonna film next at all. So I just got back from picking up my lunch because I need to eat something before I go meet Grayscale so I can like not die during the show from not having eaten all day. And I was actually really curious to see how many people are lined up, if any, because when I went to get breakfast this morning, there wasn't anybody. So after I got my food, I went and I walked to the venue. There's only like three people there. But before I even left, I was thinking, Grayscale have to be here. Like, it's like noon. They gotta do, you know, they gotta set up, they gotta like sound check, whatever. They have to be here. But like, I don't know where on this street that they would put their bus and their trailer and everything. Like, normally when I go to concerts, like the House of Blues, like for Eric Nam, both of his buses were just like on the street, not hiding anywhere, like not tucked anywhere, whatever, just plain sight right there. So I was thinking, are they gonna do that here? Like, I don't know if you can. This seems like a really busy road. I don't know. But then I had looked before I left on maps to see like where could they like tuck in a trailer maybe, or like where would there potentially be a back entrance for the venue for them to like load in all their stuff. And I think I found one. So I was like, okay, well, when I walk past the venue to see how many people are there, I could also go look and see if that is actually like a road slash if there are buses there. Well, I walk past the venue and I'm crossing the entrance to the North Station parking garage at the like corner, and I look up, and parked on the side is this like, it's like a bus, but it's not like what I would picture when I think of a tour bus. It's not like the huge long one, but all the windows were like blacked out, and there was also a trailer on the back of it, and I was like, that could be them. Okay. And I just kept walking past it, pretending like I wasn't like staring at it, because obviously if they're inside they could definitely like see me. So I like stopped a little bit further up because there was like a little like an island kind of thing, like with a tree and like flowers and stuff in it. So I just like kind of sat on the ledge. I was messaging my friend and I was like, I think I found a bus. There's a trailer on it, I don't know. And then I look up again and I see this guy with kind of messy curly brown hair either unlocking or locking like a little latch on the side. And even though I had my glasses on and I in theory should have been able to see perfectly, I was like, is that Vino? Am I seeing is that Vino? Because I couldn't see like all access pass or whatever. But then he walked over to like another one of those like island things and he had his backpack, and then I saw his like artist pass swinging around and I was like, oh my god, it's him. But I'm dumb and scared and I literally said nothing. I like slowly walked past him because I was like, okay, I need to go back to my hotel and like eat, like I need to just do that for sure. But I like slowly walked past him, but then he put his backpack on and started walking like right behind me. And I was like, do I say hi? I don't want to. Like I do, but I also like don't want to. Like I'm too scared. And then when we got to the crosswalk for the parking garage for North Station, I left him in the dust like the mass hole that I am. It was turning red and there was like 3 seconds to get across. It wasn't that long, but he stayed and I did not. And I was like, do I say hi? So I like pulled off to the side and was like DMing my friend. I was like, oh my god, it's him. Like I walked past him and I didn't say anything. Like, what do I do? Should I say hi? Like, should I stop him and say hi? And then like he comes by, I just let him walk by, and then I was like, okay, I'm not gonna say hi, I'm just gonna walk behind him, whatever, I'm just gonna go to my hotel. And then he was looking for the venue and like was kind of lost. He walked almost completely past it, and then I just kind of speed walked back to my hotel, and now here I am. I hate myself for that one. Damn it, I should have just said hi. I should have just said hi. But I also didn't want to bother him. But oh my god, I just walked past Vino so many times and I said nothing. What is wrong with me? God. So it is 3 o'clock. I think I said this earlier that our time to like be there is 4:45. I might go in like 15-30 minutes. Oh my gosh, my camera's gonna die, lol. Cute, perfect timing, I guess. But I am losing my mind. I'm so stressed. Like, I wanted to lay down because I didn't sleep at all, and I just have so much nervous energy that I can't do that. I still need to put my actual concert outfit on and just get ready to go. I'm not ready. I'm not ready to talk to them. I'm scared. I have a little speech like planned out to say to them, because if I don't say that, what I have planned, then I have nothing to say, and that's like really awkward. So one of the girlies that I am planning on meeting up with, she's already there. Another one will be there shortly after I get there, so I'm excited to meet them as well. But I'm also like, this can't be happening. This isn't real. This is a dream. Oh boy. Oh my god. Am I really about to go meet Grayscale right now? Am I gonna make it through the show? Am I gonna make it out alive from the show? I don't know. I don't know. Alright, so obviously I'm filming on my phone now. My camera died right after I filmed that last clip, but obviously my concert fit is now on. I did a poll on my Twitter a few days ago asking which shirt I should wear, because I had like a bunch of ideas basically, and most people voted for this one, so that's the one I've obviously gone with. And I've got my black high-waisted shorts on and then my sparkly Doc Marten platform shoes because I definitely need to be taller. I don't, but I just love wearing these to concerts, and I actually have supports in them this time, unlike when I went to Stray Kids in these and just had nothing and murdered my feet. I'm almost ready to go. I just need to, like, I don't know, take some Advil or something because I have a major stress headache. And then obviously put my masks on and everything. But yeah, that is the fit. I am incredibly nervous, but oh well, it's happening, so.
People, pay attention, go. Is it gonna be? The thing is, you can't, again, team, whatever.
Hello. So it is 2 days past the Grayscale concert and I am home now from Boston and I'm here to do my post-concert thoughts, recap, whatever that always ends up taking up most of my vlogs because I forget to film in the moment. I tried actually to film this yesterday morning immediately after waking up and before I left Boston just to have it done, but I did not sleep after the concert. As a result, I just was talking in circles and would lose my train of thought and just completely forget what I was talking about halfway through saying something. So a lot of the footage that I got yesterday of me talking was pretty much unusable. So I made the executive decision to just wait until now when I've kind of slept more, and I also made myself an outline so I don't get completely derailed trying to talk about everything, to just do it now. And hopefully it's a little bit more concise. However, in watching back that footage from yesterday morning, there are some moments and some things that I was describing that just the way that I said it, I thought is really funny. So I'm going to include those after this as like bloopers, just because it's my video and I can do what I want. So I ended up leaving my hotel and getting in line around 3:45, and I pretty much immediately met one of the people that I was planning on meeting up with and sticking with throughout the show, and her name is Stephanie, so I'm going to be referring to her a lot because we were hanging out the whole time. And it was great to meet her because we both had never met Grayscale before and we both were incredibly nervous, and everyone else around us was like relatively calm, so it was like nice to bond over the fact that we were both kind of losing our minds. We got checked in, we got wristbands and a stamp that is now super faded. And then they took us inside and we got situated for the Q&A, and I'm not gonna run through and like talk about everything that happened in the Q&A, but I will say once we got in and we were sitting down and once they had just walked in for the Q&A, I actually was really calm and the questions were good. Some of the questions were really funny. Their answers were really funny. I didn't really take pictures or videos during the Q&A or really most of VIP because I was a little bit intimidated to do that. I know people were doing it and it's okay, but I just didn't want to, and I was like really close behind the girls who were sitting directly in front of the table that Grayscale were sitting at. So if I wanted to like take a picture and actually have them show up in it, I would have to like put it up higher, and I just didn't want to do that. So I have like one picture where I was brave enough to do it, and then I have like one clip of Pictionary, and that's pretty much it. And then we got into Pictionary and it was an interesting time. So we had 5 teams. I think we had a decently big group. They said there were 61 of us and we were playing until any team got 4 points. So my team was doing absolutely horrendous pretty much the entire time because we either just could not tell what they were drawing, or we were just a split second off getting our whiteboard up in time. So we, for most of the game, only had like 1 point, but then one of the teams had 3 points and they were thinking, oh well, this team could just win it all in the next round and then we're done. That would be like a really quick Pictionary game. But my team was like, no, we're gonna win. We didn't actually know if that was true, but that's what ended up happening. We ended up winning, which is very exciting. And I only remember 3 of the songs that we got the point for. The first one was Motown, and Colin was drawing for that one, and all he wrote was 69. And I had seen from other people's experiences, like on Twitter, that Colin had gotten Motown before and all he wrote was 69. So as soon as I saw him write a 6, I leaned forward and told our team rep with the whiteboard, it's Motown. So we got that point really quickly, and they called us the horny team because we got that so fast, and apparently it was the fastest that any team had gotten any of the songs. So there's that. And then the next one that we got a point for was Diamond, which I was hoping that we were gonna get that one because, I mean, I feel like everyone on Grayscale Twitter has seen at least one of Colin's drawings of a diamond, and we have discussed it, and it was not good, okay? Like, it was bad. Why was it round on the top? What were all of those lines? It looked like a sleeping bag, an ice cream cone, literally not a diamond at all. Like, Colin was... But this time, he was actually drawing it like angled, like it's supposed to be, and he started out with the top of it. I apologize, there's a truck sitting outside very loudly, and I don't know when they're gonna leave, so we're just gonna have to deal with it, so I apologize.
What was I saying? Oh yes, so it was like that. And then when he started trying to draw the bottom of it, he messed up and he started erasing it, but I had already seen the top and I was like, oh my God, that has to be diamond. And so he was still erasing it and like thinking, like trying to redraw it, and we already had it up. So we didn't let him redraw anything at all. Like, we got the point before he could even fix himself. So that was funny. And then the last one that we got a point for was In My Arms, and I think Dallas was drawing for this one, and he drew a person holding a baby, and at first we thought it was baby blue, but then he drew an arrow pointing at the arm specifically, and that's when we got it. So we didn't look like we were gonna win at all, and then we just totally stole the game. So the prize was beach balls, and these were technically for throwing around in the crowd during the show, but I kept mine. So here it is. Oh, it's upside down. Looks like this. It's got the Tor, like our shamrock on it, and then the Tor name and everything. Yes, I did not blow it up so I could keep it. So there's that. All right, sorry about that. All of the trucks are now gone for the most part. They're not idling outside of my house extremely loudly, so yay. Anyway, after Pictionary, of course, was the time to do pictures with Grayscale and talk to them. And that is exactly when I started to actually get nervous, and my mouth was so dry, and that's when I started shaking yet again. So Steph and I were towards the front of the line, which was intimidating. I didn't want to be one of the first people because I kind of wanted to see how long other people were talking to them and taking with them, because I didn't want to feel like what I had planned to say was too long and like I needed to rush through it or anything. The very first few people just went, took their picture and like left. They didn't talk to Grayscale at all, and Steph and I were both freaking out because we both wanted to talk to them a little bit, but then the people right in front of us would take their picture and then turn around and talk to them for a little bit. So we were like, oh, okay, good, we can do that. We'll just take the picture first and then we'll talk to them. So Steph went first and she gave them little Shamfam bracelets that she had made for them. And they seemed really excited about them. The bracelets were super cute, and I think some of them put them on immediately, and then others I think just like put them in their pockets to save for later. She talked to them a little bit and then she went away off to the side and waited for me, because it was then my turn. And I'm just gonna say that I, in the moment, like immediately after meeting them, did not remember anything that happened. Like, I genuinely feel like I mentally was not there at all when I was meeting them. I was just so nervous and panicked about trying to make sure that I said everything that I planned to. So, you know, I gave Miz my phone for the pictures and everything, and I walked up to them and they said hi, and I like stood between Vaughn and Venti, and I had my mask on for meeting them. Well, I had it on the whole time. But Vaughn asked me how I was, and I could say, like, I could respond to him while the pictures were getting taken because I had my mask on and it wouldn't make a difference of like what my face looked like for the picture. So that was great. So I was like, oh, I'm good. How are you? And then basically after Miz was done, he's like, okay, all good. I whipped around and I started my spiel. Why am I getting so nervous talking about it and like saying what I said? But basically what I had planned to say was like, I'm so glad that you guys came around so soon after your last tour, because I wanted to see you guys in Worcester, but I couldn't make it work. And also I'm a fairly newer fan of you guys. I got into, you know, fairly recently, but I don't think I've ever so quickly connected with an artist's music and just the artist overall, nor have I ever like made friends and like found the community so fast. And I just wanted to say, you know, like, thank you all for making great music and, you know, for everything that you do for all of us, like the community number, the fun VIP things, and the Twitch streams have definitely been a highlight of my year. And then I ended it with like, and also, hi, I am your Shams note taker. I'm the one who does the pre-game notes for the Shams. And I'm not gonna lie, again, I blacked out pretty much meeting them because I was so stressed. So I, in the moment, was like not taking in anything that they said to me. So everything now that I remember, it came back to me in waves throughout the night. So I'm gonna try and run through the things that they were saying to me. But they seemed excited when I said that I was the one who takes the notes. I remember that Vaughn asked me what my username was, but I don't remember what the response to that was entirely. I know at some point Venti told me that he liked my hair color, and that threw me off because I wasn't expecting him to say anything to me or any of them to say anything to me before I started talking or like while I was talking. So that threw me off, and I think I was like, oh, thank you so much, and then I just like kept going with like my little spiel. I think they said, oh, that's so awesome, when I said I was a newer fan, but I connected really quickly with them. I don't know. I genuinely was just not, all there when they were talking to me. And also, I was trying to look at all of them. Like, I didn't know who to look at the whole time that I was talking. I was just kind of, like, looking back and forth because I wanted to feel like I was talking to all of them at the same time. But obviously, there's five of them and one of me, so I was just super stressed about that. But then I feel like by the end, I really ended up mostly like looking at Vaughn, Venti, and Colin because they were all kind of like really intensely staring at me. And they were also, it felt like, all talking to me at the same time and like making little comments about the things that I was saying all at the same time. So I was just so frazzled, and I feel like they could probably tell. So yeah, I blacked out meeting them, but I think they were excited when I said I was the Shams note taker. And I panicked and I was like, oh yeah, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. Like, I never actually meant to send my notes. Like, that was a complete accident. Like, I didn't mean to send that giant paragraph the first time that it happened, but now I just do it for fun. But, oh god, Colin said something about that and I don't remember what it was. He had like more to say than just what I remember, which is that it was a happy accident. But oh my god, I blacked out. Like, it was so bad. I don't even know, like, but it happened. I did it. I said my spiel to them successfully for the most part. And then my exit away from them was nothing short of embarrassing. I ran away from them. I was running to Steph excitedly, but I ran away from Grayscale. Why did I do that? And it wasn't even like normal running. I was like bent over. Like kind of like a Naruto run or something. Like, not with my arms back, but like, it was so bad. Like, why did I run away from them? I really hope that they don't remember that if they saw it. I really honestly hope that they were just focused on the next person coming down the stairs instead of me running away like an idiot. So that was fun. But then Steph and I had a little freak out moment like behind part of the wall. And then we went and got merch. And so I got a t-shirt and I have it here. I wasn't planning on getting anything besides the poster, but then I looked at the shirt, one of the shirts, a little bit too long, and I was like, actually, it's kind of cute and I kind of want it. So I got, it's like the number one t-shirt on the thing, but this one looks like this on the front, and then all the tour dates are on the back and everything. And then I also got a poster for me and one for my friend Missy. Hi Missy, if you're watching. And I put them in our merch bags to try and keep them safe during the show, but it was a little rough, so they got crushed, but it's fine. There is a crease in the middle. I had them rolled up in the bag and then they obviously got folded right here, but it's all signed by Grayscale, and like some of the bottom corners are a little bit crusty and gross, but it's a cute poster. I'm glad I got one, and I'm glad that they are not more banged up than I thought they were. I thought they were just obliterated in my bag, but they turned out pretty okay. So yeah, we got some merch, and then we just hung out and waited for everyone else to get their pictures done because obviously we were at the front. And oh yes, we of course were looking at our pictures with them. Miz took 5 pictures on my phone and I got a range of faces, particularly from Colin, and Steph and I were losing our minds over it because of some of them. I really like my pictures. I can't decide which one I like the best, which is why at the current time I have not posted publicly, at least. I posted one on my close friend story. I kind of look at them every once in a while and I switch out which one's my favorite in the moment. And then we took our group photo, and after we did that, it was already, I think, like 6:30 by the time that we finished doing the group photo. And I knew from seeing other people's experiences that like Grayscale kind of linger before the doors open and everything. They couldn't really linger for that long. Like, pretty much immediately after we took our picture, the tour manager was like, Colin, come on, we gotta go. Like, Colin, let's go. But he was basically swarmed by so many people because everybody wanted to talk to him. So it took him a hot second to be able to get out. So that was kind of sad, but it's okay. We'll get to that though. But Vino and Vaughn hung around for a little bit. I don't remember seeing Venti or Dallas after we took the picture at all. I genuinely don't know where they went. But Steph and I met the MVP from the Twitch streams, and that was very exciting. She's great, she's so nice, and we just stuck with her for the show as well. And we were also with another person, but I didn't get their name, and I feel really bad about it because they were so awesome and they were super nice too. And we stuck around as a group of four for a while. The show pretty much started like half an hour after VIP ended, and they started letting people in, albeit a little bit late. And so the Ivy came on, and they were really good. I didn't really know what to expect with the Ivy because, listen, I'm not gonna lie, like, I was there mostly just for Grayscale. I didn't know any of the other artists that were there. Sorry. And I did try before the concert to listen to at least a few of the songs beforehand just to know what I was getting myself into and what to expect. But just in the stress of thinking about meeting Grayscale, just did not end up listening to the Ivy for no reason. But they were really good. I really liked their music. I was just vibing and jamming out the whole time that they were on, and I definitely want to go check out their songs and see if I can find the ones that they were performing, because I really like them. I was having a great time. And the crowd at that point was really empty and spaced out, and we were confused in the moment. We were like, there's no way that this crowd is gonna be this empty. We thought they sold this thing out. Like, what? But it's probably because doors opened so late, so people were still making their way in, of course. And it definitely filled in as the night went on. So during the Ivy, it was a little empty, but I feel like everybody was, you know, vibing out to it. And I think there were some crowd surfers for it, particularly on the left side, but I also can't remember. And then Bearings came on, and it was definitely a lot busier when they were there. And I feel like I should say this now before I continue talking about the show, but just as like a disclaimer, you're gonna hear me say a lot probably that this show was like super rough and intense for me, because pretty much exclusively for the past few years I've been really only going to K-pop concerts. So like moshing and circle pits and crowd surfers have not been an experience for me at a concert in 5 years. So for me, it was a rough experience, and I was not quite used to getting shoved in every direction all at once and having to pay attention and make sure I was watching out for crowd surfers behind me. But obviously I knew that that was gonna happen. I was just not expecting like how rough it got so quickly. I just forgot like what it was like to be in that kind of crowd, because I'm just not used to it anymore. But yeah, so Bearing set is when it started getting really rough, and there was a lot of circle pits, particularly on the side that we were on. So that was fun, trying to enjoy the music and jam out, but also make sure that I was paying attention so I could help people surf. But it was fun, it was good. I definitely wanna go and check out their music as well. And then their set was over, and I was so hot after that that I left the pit to go get some water. I think the whole group of us, I think we all left to like get water and just like chill where it was a little bit cooler. And then Garden came on shortly after we all left, and I stayed out of the pit for his set, or for the first like third of his set. Garden's music personally is just not really my vibe, and I know very much about all of the drama about him being on the tour, basically, because I am chronically online and I saw everything on Twitter, of course. So all I'm gonna say is his music is not for me. However, there were a lot of people at the show who were there specifically for him, and the crowd was actually really receptive of him and really excited for him. Like, when we all eventually came back down into the crowd towards the middle of his set, I want to say, there were people opening up pits for him, there were people crowd surfing for him, there were people, you know, they were just having a grand old time. So that was, I guess, nice to see especially after like hearing about all the drama. But then all of the people that were there for Garden basically left immediately after Garden finished his set, and so my little group, we all got a lot closer than we were, and we ended up basically in the middle, right in front of where Colin's microphone was gonna be. And then they came on, and it went by so fast that it didn't even feel like it was happening at all. I was like, there's no way that they're almost done. Are you kidding me? Why is this so short? Like, why are we almost done? Like, I think we got to like Over Now, which is somewhere in the middle of the set list, and I was like, holy crap, they're almost done. What the heck? It's been like 2 seconds. So that was an experience. The crowd was very rough during Grayscale. There were a lot of surfers and a lot of circle pits, like pretty much the entire time actually, except for during the like slower songs. That was a nice break. There was just like 3, 4, 5 crowd surfers all at the same time, particularly on Vaughn's side and also in front of Colin, so like the middle and our left, their right, which was of course right over us and our little group of people. So that was stressful, but the staff at the venue were absolutely fantastic. Like, they were all lined up at the barricade ready to go. There was like honestly 10 security guards like shoulder to shoulder watching, and like, if you know, I was trying to pay attention too to make sure that I could help crowd surfers, and I tried to make sure that I always had a hand free to be able to, you know, grab anything that I could, lift them up any way that I could. But if I was like a little too immersed in the moment and in the show, I could still see and tell that crowd surfers were potentially going to be coming over me, because I could see the security guards getting up and getting ready to grab them. So I would turn around, see them coming, and know that I needed to help or not, because there was just so many on the left side and so many started coming down the middle. I don't know like necessarily the best way to explain this. Like, I think the show was great. Obviously they sounded great. It was super fun. But I also feel like I personally had a little bit of a hard time balancing helping out the crowd surfers as best as I possibly could, but also focusing on the show at the same time. It was just really hard trying to keep my balance and stay on my feet, being pushed in every single direction all at once, at the same time as like 3, 4, 5 crowd surfers all coming at the same time, and like trying to have a hand free for them, to, you know, make sure that they're safe. Obviously we don't want people to get dropped. Like, we want them to stay up and stay safe and not get injured. So yeah, I personally had a hard time trying to find a good balance between making sure I was present for the show, but also making sure that I was aware when a crowd surfer was coming. Like, I don't know, I felt like torn. I didn't know what to do, and I feel like at a certain point I just kind of turned to the side completely so that I could like watch, and I was just like constantly looking back just to make sure. But there was one moment that is like kind of funny but also not. So during Dirty Bombs, one of my favorite Grayscale songs, of course I wanted a video of that, duh. So it's right at the start of Vaughn's guitar solo, you just hear me yell, "Yes, Vaughn!" You see the crowd surfer come down, me scream in like a panic, and then the video just cuts off. And like, I find it funny now, but in the moment when I realized, oh my god, it turned my video off, I was so upset, because I love Dirty Bombs and I wanted a whole video of it, but obviously the crowd surfer's safety is more important. Oh yes, how could I forget the reason my neck hurts so bad? A crowd surfer basically like landed on my head and neck. I don't remember what song it was during, but I just remember all of a sudden my head is down like this. I almost lost my glasses, and I was scared in that moment for me and for the crowd surfer, because I was like, I'm trying not to fall over, but I also don't want to be the reason that this person gets dropped. So I was like trying my hardest to like lift them off of me. And then by the end of the show, I think the end of the show, the last couple songs, was probably the roughest that the crowd was. Like, I just remember I turned around and like pretty much the entire back half was just this giant circle pit, and I just remember like being crushed against the guy in front of me like this, and I was just like desperately trying to stay on my feet, and I was really scared in those moments that I was gonna fall over. Like, we were being pushed like really aggressively, and I definitely was going to fall over if I did not manage to catch my balance, but I didn't. I was able to, you know, get my balance. For that giant circle pit, I remember I turned around and I just remember I was like, oh my God, that's Bearings. Bearings is in the circle pit right now. Like, I recognized a couple of them. I think it was only a couple of them. Maybe it was all of them. I don't know. But I just recognized, like, their shirts, and one of them had a Patriots hat on. They both actually surfed pretty much, like, right over me. So I was like, okay, let's go. Sure. So lifted one of them up and over, and then the one in the Patriots hat also surfed right over us. So that was an experience. I don't know if they've done that at other dates. I haven't seen anyone say that they have. Maybe they did. I don't know. But that was kind of cool that they surfed like right over us during the last songs. But yeah, it was great. They sounded great, of course. It was just a fun time. I had a lot of fun seeing a lot of my favorite songs live. Like, pretty much the whole middle of the set list was a lot of my favorite songs. So it was great, like, hearing those live for the first time ever. And how could I forget yet again? Colin took his shoes off partway through the show. I don't know when he took them off. It was somewhere in the middle, I think. But I just remember the crowd in front of me parted just right, and I managed to look down and I was like, oh my God, he's just in his socks. Where are his shoes? When did he take his shoes off? But I was just like, oh, why has he got the dogs out? Almost. I mean, he's wearing socks, but he's got the dogs out. Why? I don't know if he does that at other shows or if that was just like a fuck it kind of moment, because it was the last day and he was just feeling it. But yeah, he took his shoes off. But yeah, so then show ended, most people just started heading out. A lot of people went back to go get some merch because they didn't do it beforehand, maybe. And also Bearings were at their merch table, so people wanted to say hi, of course. Me, Steph, and Em kind of like stuck around, and we were waiting to see if they would come back out and like maybe mill around a little bit, but they did not. So also the venue staff were trying kind of desperately to get us out so that they could clean the venue, because there was a lot of trash on the ground. I felt so bad. So Steph and I headed outside, and we went down to where their bus was, and we sat for a little bit of time, but then Steph had to leave, so I ended up just chilling there by myself. And I've never actually waited outside of an artist's bus and trailer before for any show. I usually just leave and go to my hotel and sleep afterwards. But I was like, you know what? Why not? I'm having a lot of firsts today. So, you know, my first time in the North End, first time at this venue, first time seeing Grayscale, whatever. Why not just try? So I just sat by their bus and waited for them to see if they would come out. I was one of the very few people sitting out there, because I don't know if people knew that that was their bus and that it was kind of close to the venue. I was debating leaving when the bus started moving, because I was like, oh, like, it's gonna go all the way down there. They're not gonna come, you know, I'm not gonna meet them. I should probably just leave. But I decided to wait because I saw a few other people that I knew were gonna be there, and I actually was supposed to hang out with them and like meet up with them for the show, but then I just didn't end up doing that at all. But I saw them waiting, and I knew that they had always, in the dates that they were kind of following the show, always gotten pictures with them at the end of the show. So I was like, I should probably just stick around and kind of hover around wherever they are, because I feel like they know what they're doing. I think there's four of them. There was a group of three people who really wanted to meet Garden after the show, me and then two other girls, and we were all just kind of hovering around each other and like waiting for them to come out. And we were seeing them bringing stuff to the bus, and talking to each other. It was like all the bands and all their vans were down there as well. And then the tour manager was leaving, and Vaughn came up to the street to say goodbye to him. And then the group of four, they were the ones that Grayscale knew, like during VIP and everything. They kind of like, just I think asked Vaughn if they could just go down there to say goodbye, and so they went down there. And then the three people who wanted to see Garden stayed for a little bit longer, and then they ended up going down as well. But the other two girls that were waiting at the street at the same level as me, like, we felt really nervous about that. We were like, should we go down too? Like, I feel like we shouldn't, like, we weren't really invited. Like, they're all trying to say their final goodbyes because it's the last day of the tour. Like, they're all gonna go their separate ways. So we just kind of moved a little bit closer to the bus to make it a little bit more obvious that we were waiting too, to say hi to them. but we didn't want to like go down unless they invited us down, so we just kind of like stood around awkwardly like waiting. But Colin noticed us standing up towards the street, and he like had turned around a couple times and was like looking at us. But then after a few minutes, and after he looked at us like the second time, he started coming up the hill towards us, but we weren't sure if we should start going towards him at all, because we didn't know if he was just coming up to like get something out of the bus or like put something back in the bus. And then it became obvious that he was coming to us when he waved at us, so we just kind of met him in the middle, and he was very sweet. He thanked us for being patient and like not going down there. He apologized for being smelly because he hasn't been able to do laundry in a while, or in a few days, I think he said. But yeah, he was super sweet, and he was asking us, you know, how we were, how the show was, if we had a good time. And the other girls wanted him to sign something and to take pictures with him and everything. And then obviously, of course, that's also why I was there. But I don't like talking about this. I don't know how much detail I'm gonna go into about the interaction, because I have been overthinking it ever since it happened, because it was like kind of awkward and really cringy for me personally. I'm sure he didn't care and he's not even gonna remember it, but God. Again, why can't I be normal when I meet my faves? My mind just went like blank. Like, I am very much a person who thrives on like having a plan for everything, and even though I had planned to attempt to go stand out by the bus and try and meet them after the show, I didn't use the 3 hours of time that it took to meet them to actually have something to say. So I basically word vomited so hard at him, but also stuttered a lot, and also could not form words because I was so intimidated and so nervous. And I don't think I'm gonna say what I said. I mean, it wasn't anything bad, but I'm just so embarrassed. But again, he was very sweet about it. But the one thing I will say is, after I word vomited at him, I didn't get the chance to take a picture with him because he started asking the other girls about something that was like related to what I had word vomited. And so he was basically like having a conversation with them, but while he was doing that, he was kind of like turning a lot towards like down the hill where the rest of the groups were, almost as if he was like trying to like get out and leave and kind of be done talking to us. And I was panicking because I was like, oh my god, I want a picture with him, but I didn't get to ask because I was just so panicked and I couldn't even get words out in general, and then I said stupid things to him. So I was like, oh my god, what do I do? Like, I don't want him to leave. I want to take a picture with him too. But I didn't even have to ask him once he was done talking to them, because he saw that I had my camera open. He was like, oh, do you want a picture too? And I was like, yes, please. So the girls very kindly took a few pictures of us together, and then he, you know, thanked us again for being patient and thanked us for our support and told us to get home safe. And then he headed back down to where the rest of the groups were. And then at that point, Venti had to come past us. He was on a mission to go somewhere. I don't know where he was off to, but he was real quick about it, and he talked to the other girls. I think he recognized them, maybe, and he took pictures with them and signed stuff for them, and then immediately dipped. So I didn't get to talk to him at all, didn't get a picture with him like I wanted, but it's okay, he was very much on a mission, he was out of there. And then Vaughn didn't ever come back after he went down with the group of four. Vino left before anyone came up to the street level at all. I don't know where he was going either, and then I just never saw Dallas, so I'm glad that I waited the 3 hours because it was definitely worth it. And the pictures are really cute, so I think, anyway. But yeah, that was my experience seeing and meeting Grayscale for the first time. I definitely want to go see them again and potentially meet them again, hopefully, if that ever happens in the future. I won't mess it up so badly and I won't be so awkward and run away from them or word vomit at them if I meet them after the show. But yeah, that was my experience. I had a good time. It still doesn't feel real. I tried listening to literally any of their music yesterday on the way home, and I just pretty much immediately started tearing up because I was so overwhelmed just remembering everything that happened. So yeah, it was a really good time. I'm glad that I just bit the bullet and did it, even though I was so nervous about it. because I had a great time, and they were super nice, super awesome guys, so yeah, it was fun. But yeah, I think that is finally the end of my recap. I feel like I ended up talking for just as long as I did yesterday, when I pretty much said nothing yesterday. But yeah, I think that's all. So all that's left now, if you're still here, is the like bloopers-ish of the first time I talked about the experiences. So enjoy those if you're still here.
Someone asked like what dog breed they think they would all be, and they did not know like any. They were struggling, so they just turned it back around on the person who asked the question, and they were like, what do you think we would be? And then they were like, oh, it's not so fun when it's you, is it? They talked about a shootout question mark, or a shooting that happened at a restaurant or a bar that they were at in a different state. I don't remember which one, so I'm not even gonna try. And apparently someone's ear had been bitten off, and it was like on the, I don't know. It was really a lot. But then Colin said that like a peak was in New York City. They went on like a horse-drawn carriage ride. I guess they had asked them like, what's your favorite color? Or like, what's your favorite color today? I think Vaughn just pointed to the blue lights and said that shade of blue. And then Vino said royal blue. Venti said black. Colin said lavender. And I don't remember what Dallas said. Oh my God, why do I not remember what Dallas said? Anyway, or we just couldn't tell what they were drawing. We were like, what is that supposed to be? Once Venti was like, oh, like this team could win it all. They've got 3 points. Like they could win and we're done. Well, my team said, no, 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 we're gonna win. And that is exactly what we did, because I had seen from other people's VIPs that that's what he had drawn for Motown. Drawn. I think I was the one who told the person with the whiteboard what it was. And then it was my turn, and I was like, oh my God, I'm scared. I can't fully remember everything that they were saying back to me. Like, I know that at some point Venti told me that he liked my hair, and that threw me off. I think that was right before I started my speech. I don't know. But he told me that he liked my hair, so I was like, oh, thank you. And then I just kept going, and then, oh my God, I don't remember anything. Like, I literally, like, I blacked out. Like, I was like, I didn't know who to look at either. That was really stressful. I was like trying to like talk to all of them, like, so I was just like swiveling my head back and forth like the whole time. But then after a certain point, I somehow only ended up like really looking at Vaughn, Venti, and Colin, because they were all like staring at me, and I was like, oh my God. And they were also the ones who were like talking to me like kind of all at the same time. At least that's what it felt like in the moment. I don't remember what they were saying to me about Twitch and like about me being the note taker, but I know Colin was saying something. I just can't remember. But then I was like, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. Like, that was, I never meant to send my notes. It was a complete accident. Like, it's like I was like panicking because I didn't mean to send like a giant paragraph or whatever. And then I just remember Colin saying that it was a happy accident. And I don't remember anything after that. Like, I know that there was something said after that. And then my exit was nothing but embarrassing. I ran away from Grayscale. Why did I do that? So that was embarrassing. I really hope they didn't see that. And I think, was it that point? No, it was during Grayscale that somebody landed on my head. Anyway, Barings was good. A little rough, but it was a preview, let's say, for Grayscale. And I was like so overwhelmed. I was like blanking on the words for like all the songs. I genuinely just could not remember the words. So I word vomited at him very awkwardly. Ew. God, I'm just like remembering it, and I'm like, why did I do that? Why did I say the things that I did? Like, ew. And then I didn't get a picture with him after I started talking to him, or after I word vomited at him, because he started talking to the other girls again, and they were like having a whole conversation that was like semi-related to what I had said. Like, even though I didn't mean to say that at all. Oh my God, I hate myself for saying it. Oh my God. Jesus Christ, why do I mess everything up? And at that point, Venti had come up, and he was going somewhere. I don't know where. But he took a picture with and signed things for the two other girls. And then I wanted a picture with him, but he like immediately ran away. And I was like, oh, okay. Then I guess we're done here. Like, I guess I'm gonna go back to my hotel. And that's exactly what I did. And I just was losing my mind. I was like, I just met Colin after the show. I word vomited at him. I was like freaking out mostly about the word vomit. I feel like I was like not all there for the whole experience. Like, I was like in and out of like actually experiencing it and then just freaking out inside. And there were some points during the show where I was kind of realizing, oh my God, I like met them and I talked to them. And I started getting really emotional. I almost started crying like multiple times. He's so goofy admitting that. But yeah, I met Grayscale. Oh my God. Like, it still doesn't feel real at all. Like, I came back after saying goodbye to Colin and then being blown off by Venti. And I just like didn't know what to do with myself when I came back to the hotel. I was like, well, first and foremost, I freaked out about word vomiting at him. And I was like sending the picture to like everybody. Yeah, I was so embarrassed. Like, I genuinely started like tearing up out of embarrassment that happened. Cause I'm like, oh my God, like, why did I say that? And still now I'm like, why did I say the things to him that I did? Like, that was so stupid. You could have literally said anything else and that's what you decided to say. Cool. I mean, it wasn't anything like bad. It was just like, why? I don't even want to watch my videos back. They're probably so horrendous with like me just like screaming whatever lyrics I could actually remember, because I blanked so hard on all of the songs. I was like, suddenly I don't know where I am. It was just so overwhelming. Oh my God, Colin wasn't wearing shoes on stage. I don't know if he came out not wearing shoes. He had his socks on. He did not have the dogs out. But the dogs were trying to escape, at least on one foot. I just remember catching a glimpse, because the people in front of me had like moved just right, and I caught a glimpse and I was like, oh my God, he's not wearing shoes, he's just in socks. What? So that was an interesting experience. But yeah, there's that. It just doesn't feel real. Like, I saw them, I met them, I ran away from them like a freak, I word vomited at Colin, and now it's over. It was fun. It was a lot of firsts. I definitely, again, am beating myself up over it. I would definitely go see them again. And hopefully next time I won't mess up the experience so badly for myself with my nervousness. I don't know what I would say to them the next time I see them, but we'll figure that out later. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it. I'm also excited to get my pictures developed. I think I took 7 or 8 pictures on my disposable camera. We had someone take a picture of me, Steph, and M together, or 2 pictures, one horizontal, one upright. So those were the first 2 pictures on the camera, and we took those in the crowd. And then during the show, I remembered suddenly that I had the camera, and I was like, oh my God, wait, I wanted to try and take pictures during the show with the camera instead of my phone. And then I had the flash on for one of them, but then the security guards all started looking at me after that, and I was like, oh my God, no. That was bad. But then I think in songs where the lighting was a lot brighter behind them, I didn't have the flash on, so I don't know how those photos are gonna turn out. I think I took like 2 or 3 that way. But then it was just so crazy that I couldn't do that. I had to put it away because of the crowd surfers, because obviously their safety is more important than like me getting nice pictures. I had a few left, and now I don't know what to take to use up those pictures, but I wanna do something. So maybe I'll figure something out while I'm like packing, because I actually have spent so much time filming that I really have to go like ASAP. So hopefully this vlog was somewhat entertaining. I feel like it's mostly just me talking about the experience and just me cringing about how stupid I am. Oh my God, I just can't believe it. Oh my God, I just can't believe it. Like, it doesn't feel real. I don't know if it will ever feel real that I like met them
and I talked to them, and then I met Colin afterwards. Oh my god, this camera needs to get a grip. Stop falling over. Even the camera doesn't want me to film anymore. But yeah, like, I know Brittany Broski said this about meeting Harry Styles. She was like, when I watched that video back, I'm like, oh, good for her. I don't know who that is. That's not me. That's how I feel about meeting Grayscale and, like, talking to Colin. I'm like, I look at my pictures and I'm like, good for that girl. I don't know who the hell she is, but that was not me. Like, oh my god, it just doesn't feel real. Oh my god. Oh my god. But yeah, I need to shut up and go. So yeah. Hopefully this was somewhat entertaining. Grayscale, if you see this, I really hope you don't, actually. But thanks for a great night. Sorry for word vomiting at you and running away from you in VIP.
But yeah, that is all for this video, and I will see you in my next one.